Yeah, we gon' talk, we gon' have fun. We be on fire, we be lit lit. It's a unique hustle, big shit. Big shit,
big shit,
big shit. It's a unique hustle, nigga, big shit. Big shit,
big shit,
big shit. Name another podcast like this.
Check it, check it, check it. It's a unique house. It's your boy, ECO, and I'm here with the lovely official, Miss Jamaica. What's going on?
Nothing, my day walk on.
We down here in Atlanta, man.
Yes, sir.
Say, man, it's going down, man.
You did.
Say, man, we got the best guest in Atlanta. Stop playing, man.
Stop.
Hey, man, Mykko Montana. Mykko Montana is in the building.
Yes, sir.
What's
yes,
going sir. On?
I'm blessed, bro. How you doing?
Man, you here now?
Yep.
You made it.
I just got to say this. I love that name, Mykko.
Thank you.
It is. Where did you get it from?
My real name is Mykko.
So
Mykchael.
So you came up with the name Mykko?
Yeah, I broke it down.
Mm.
I broke Mykko down because I, you know what I'm saying, we were trying to keep it like me. You know what I'm saying? So we didn't want to go like, I had cameras called Swagger Right, J. Mykko, Swagger Right. Mm-hmm. We were coming up with numerous names, you know what I'm saying? But then I was like, I want to keep it more of me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, your name is important. You know what I'm saying?
It's so important.
Yeah. And then a little about me, you know what I'm saying? So I want to stick with, you know, the culture, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. NYKO. But we just add another K, you know what I'm saying? But it's NYKO, you know what I'm saying?
Well,
Mykko.
We know the Montana, right?
Yeah.
We already know, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I've been trying to take that out for a long time, but it just it ring, because, you know, I don't want to look too more into what Montana means. So I just want I want the people to think of it like, I want it to ring to you. It's art. I want you to think of it like art. Don't be too deep in it and think like Montana. Is he trying to like, because they got on me for a little bit about that, like, oh, you dope, like, no, bro. It's like, I want you to pay attention to what, like, the scene, the sound of it, Mykko Montana. Like, you got a ring to it, so that's what I wanted to keep.
Man,
I wanted to see that. Could they repeat that a lot? Could they, you know what I'm saying? I played with that name for a little bit.
When was that name created? How old were you?
I believe I probably like in 09. I can't remember how old I was, but it was probably like in 09. Around that time?
Yeah,
2009, 2010.
Is that when you started?
11.
Oh, okay.
Yep. I popped like, 2013, 2014. I took it serious like, 2013, 2012, shit like that.
Y'all been together a long time. Mm-hmm. You keep looking back like confirmation. Mm-hmm.
That's good that you have people around you.
No, they both get down. You know that.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know. So they both been acting a fool in that studio, man. It's a problem.
Yeah, it definitely is.
Yeah, so how is it, man? It's oversaturated. Some good, some bad. We got trash in Dallas, man.
Mm-hmm.
We got trash in Houston. Mm-hmm. We got some trash in San Antonio. But do y'all have trash in Atlanta?
Mm-mm.
Everything
He's
good.
Mm-mm.
So yeah, but now we got greats now. Don't get it twisted.
Yeah, like I feel like trash is just something that, you know what I'm saying, as what it is.
Yeah. Trash. Now, when I say that, I'm talking about lyrically, they not going to make it. Like, but they keep throwing songs at you. And I know
Hey,
my boy, like, I don't know about that.
No. I'm with you.
I'm just trying to figure out how it go, because everywhere you go, you got a lot of rappers down. Everybody want to rap, my nigga.
It's saturated.
Everybody. Okay.
But I get it. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like, and this might just be, bro, how I talk, bro. I talk with experience.
I get it.
What I'm saying?
And, yeah, I see.
And, yeah, and due to the fact that I know, like, I was a trash rapper.
Whoa.
Like, I knew my words didn't match. I knew I was cussing too much.
Okay.
Because I couldn't, you know, when you cuss a lot, you really don't have more words. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, yeah.
You're not reading enough books. You know what I'm saying? You're not extending your brain.
That's exactly how I feel about, you know, cursing.
Well, how did you feel when I was cursing? You know, I'm ready. I just like to curse.
Sometimes some people are part of their environment as well. Mm-hmm. Some people can be as smart as a whip, but because of how they were raised and what they're around is the reason why they do it.
Okay. Yep. Oh, you analyze me. Now you a psychotherapist or something around this thing.
I ain't heard you say not one cuss word.
I don't. No more, but I do. I can. Yeah. I'm good at it.
Let me tell you, I'm one of the best to do it.
You know what I'm talking about? Yeah,
but guess what though? But so then on top of that, due to the fact that you are the best to do it, so that means in due time, the best to do it, your next artist might come out of San Antonio. Like,
yeah.
I have grew to learn, like, people don't see the, like, they're not real spiritual thinkers like us, like that. Mm-hmm. So they ain't gonna really be critiquing themselves. Like, a lot of people, you'll think that they'll critique themselves, like,
they won't.
So okay. That's where I'm not against trash. I'm not against.
Not saying it don't exist, but
I'm not against people who trying to figure it out.
That's a good. You saying people evolve, and so you like, okay, trash is a little heavy for them. They just trying to learn.
Hey man,
trying to see who they are.
Yeah.
Hey man,
and he said I was trash. That's what tripped me out when you said that. I see what angle you coming from
because now they can't do nothing with me
already.
You feel me?
I definitely feel you.
But that's where growth come from. You have to go up and you have to go down and up and to get to that point where you like, and even then. There's always more growth.
Yeah, it do. It don't stop. It only stop if you stop. Mm-hmm. So, like, the artists in Atlanta, bro, we dope. Artists across the globe, like, y'all really need to go listen to artists overseas.
I've been hearing that. I got a lot of people that have been coming on my platform saying they get not only, they get loops from overseas. They get, the producers get loops from overseas. I went platinum overseas with an artist that was from over. I went platinum over there, so I get where you're coming from with that. But hey, Atlanta's a problem. Y'all niggas just wild and out over here.
Yeah,
you
know what I'm
talking about? Go ahead.
We got to keep it going.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But then, again.
They say y'all the new Hollywood. I didn't mean to cut you off, but they act like y'all got it. Tyler Perry, all y'all. Y'all got some stuff going on down there.
Yeah, this shit lit. Yeah. You come down here and get your light cut on quick. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? You from any state, any city, you come down here, you get your lights cut on quick.
Yeah, but it's going to either tell you who you are, it's going to either make or break you, too.
You got to be ready for that.
You see what I'm saying? You can't come down here like you just going to do something if you ain't got nothing.
We be excited about Texas, too, though.
Yeah, like. We got some, come on, we got that heat over there. I mean, you know, but that's the South. Now, you know, I'm messed up because I go for the South. I ain't going to lie to you.
But you know what,
I fight hard for the Migos, you, anybody that's, because of the way we talk and being in the South, mm-hmm. I don't play about us. Mm-hmm. I'm real serious about, you can't say nothing about us. Mm-hmm. You can't say mumble rap, none of that
you
stuff
see the
to
way,
me.
You see what I said, what I said. You see the way I said, what I said.
But let me ask you a question. You being in Atlanta, because I actually, to a lot of people in Texas, mm-hmm. but do you think it's true that when you're starting off mm-hmm. and you're to build your business that you have to, out of all the cities that you have to go through to build, Texas should be one of your number ones? Why?
I mean, it's just like that. We connected to them. They're like brothers and sisters. Like they have a big state just like we are. You know what I'm saying? Like you got to visit Texas. That after you leave Texas, you got to go to New York.
Wow.
Like, you got to go to Atlanta.
Yeah.
Like, you got to go to these big places because it's places like y'all sit in them higher places. Like,
yeah.
They can clear. All right, cool. You got to go to California, bro. You got to go there. Then, once you hit these big states, okay, then you're going to start following up on the Ohio. You're going to start Memphis. You're going to start, it all branch out. But you leave Atlanta, either you're going to go to New York, Cali, or Texas.
Let me ask you this. Let's get to the music, man.
To me.
So, when you first came out, mm-hmm. What do you think? Because you say you held back for a minute. They know the old you. They don't know the new you. What's the difference?
Oh, my growth.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's a whole lot. It's oh, man. I'm very proud of myself, like, due to the fact of, like, coming up under the how can you say it? I don't like saying it, but I dealt with it. Like the one hit wonders, like those like the downfalls of the industry. Like my buddies tell you, like I ain't think you were gonna do that. I'm just honestly like I didn't. Oh, bro, we're gonna beatbox. We're gonna rap every day. Like no, we're playing back. Whatever we were doing then, we still whether you grown or not, bro, we still have like. Kid in us, like, you know what I'm saying? Nobody was telling me to still go to Six Flags, or we might go to, like, on our downtown golf cart, or, you know, just doing normal stuff, bro, just to keep me sane. You know what I'm saying? Because the industry will drain you. Like, bro, it ain't that. I had one song, and y'all ain't hear the rest of the music, but it was just that I had gotten inside of a contract, bro. That's why y'all didn't, you know what I'm saying? And it ain't y'all business to know that it's all good. So, and I accepted it. So it's like, from this day forward, they're gonna see a more humble, respectable, you know what I'm saying, face. Like, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You now you're gonna be able to say, Mykko, he look like this, he got this on, he do this, he from this area, instead of just saying who?
Mm-hmm. Oh, really?
The do it boy, or nah? Nah, so now the executives and people who I never burned bridges with, or my colleagues or cameramans, I try to keep better relationships now. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And understand where they're coming from, their time that they're taking out. So I'm asking you shit, bro. What you know what I'm saying? I don't want it for free. What you gonna charge me? Mm-hmm. And don't hit me with the, oh bro, I'm fucking with you. Hit me with the honest answer.
Let's do business.
Like
yeah. Let's
I
do
like
business.
The humility and the honesty.
Let me ask you this. Like the little say, check it out. I come at you like this. Mm-hmm. We had a song called My Dougie in Dallas.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And then they took it up to California and they did it a different way. And they took the song and they reinvented it to and it almost seems as if it came from there. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So have anybody ever came at you, took something that you created and redone it or done something with it and made it look to as if it wasn't yours?
Mm-mm.
So you never had nobody to steal anything from you, come at you in a different way? Because this is a large market, man. I got another homegirl I just got on the phone with EXO earlier. She said Big Sean took her song, and I looked at her song way long time ago, and guess what? Mm-hmm. It was the exact same damn song. And the video was done in a football field. Hers was just low budget because she's not a known artist.
I'm thankful.
All I'm saying is Cardi B just came out with that song, right?
Mm-hmm.
And
it's a song out. Something been coming across my desk lately.
Okay.
About a certain song. It been coming across my desk. I'm like, mm-mm. And last night, it hit me again because somebody in a higher place had hit me. I'm going to take it further. He said, I'm going to take this further and see, is it true? I said, okay, cool. We're going to talk. All right, cool. Let me know that. Now, until that happened, then I'm better come back to you tell you, like, yeah, that shit happened to me. The honest, the God truth, Lil Uzi Vert. Salute to him. Salute to him and his team. And, you know what I'm saying? And that whole situation, because for the people who didn't know Do It or wasn't familiar with Do It, like the younger generation who look up to Uzi, who listen to Uzi, like, he just read, like, know how God work, you know, he just put it on somebody else's heart, like, you know what I'm saying, bring that out, like, he worked ways that you probably wouldn't even imagine.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
He's big enough for the job.
Yes.
You just gotta be appreciative for every little thing you get.
Yeah. And then when he did that, I ain't gonna lie, like, he sparked more, and like, he sparked, like, oh, shit, oh, dang. What the hell he was at when this song came out? And when he told me, I'm like, for real? My spirit and... Like, bro, you can lose you can lose the love for the game.
Mm-hmm.
It's true.
Wow.
Like, especially when you don't have honest people around you, supportive people around you to keep your head in the mental space, and it's just, you just got to always stay in the mental space. Like, that's going to, at the end of the day, what we mean, bro, it's going to cram my mind. I'm like, fuck this rap shit. I don't want to deal with it. I don't want to record. I don't want to listen. Like, I don't want to talk to no lawyers because it's too much and it's a lot that comes with it. So it's like, make so much of creative sound and so much of creative music to it, but if they do it, then just look at it like you're an icon. Like, I want them to do it, bro. Like, it's cool. I want you to go. That's what I do it for. If I didn't want you to know it, bro, I wouldn't be rapping. You would never see it if I don't bring it outside my house or if I don't post it.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted you to see it, so I wanted, like, I know you ain't gonna have these bells. So if I hear these bells, dun, 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 if I hear that shit somewhere, I'm gonna be like, bro, you know.
How long did it take you to discover yourself? To discover who you are in the music industry and your style, all of that?
All right. Honestly, it just started happening.
I'm feeling that. I seen you on that stage, man.
Mm-hmm. It just happened like
I keep seeing that.
I think God brought my spirit. Like, I got shot. He didn't break it, no, nothing like that. Like, I guess I didn't see myself. You know what I'm saying? And when I thought I was seeing myself, how about that?
Mm-hmm.
And when I thought I was seeing myself in a certain light, he just reminded me, like, okay, cool, you tripping. So I'm gonna go ahead and let something happen to you. And it's gonna mentally exercise you. It's gonna slow you down. I'm like, what? Boom! It already done happened. I ain't got shot. Ooh, so wow. So now. You know, some people are like, oh, perfect, woo woo. I didn't go through the mental, like, I was going through the mental breakdown. I was like, damn, where everybody at?
Wow.
So that's how I found myself in 2019. Like, to like not find myself to start treating other people negative or start like trying to step on people. It just showed me like move a certain kind of way so I don't have to disrespect. I just gonna disconnect myself.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So quarantine really built me. Like it really made me feel like, because I thought I had something going. I thought I had, you know, I thought I was on the road. I thought, you know what I'm saying? This is some shit that you know, we people, bro. You gonna tell yourself something in your head, you're gonna believe it. I'm looking around, yeah, damn. I'm tired of hearing do it too.
Mm-hmm.
I'm tired of posting it. I ain't tired of posting it, but it's like, if I don't put out what I've been working on, then you know, I'm scared of, cause due to the fact of like how I've been treated. Mm-hmm. Like, these folks want something that's bigger than do it. They want like, for real, man.
Man, I talk to a lot of artists that can't, you know, get past that song, that one song or that one situation, and it's that and it was a mental breakdown to where I know they're still going through trying to figure it out right now. If something was done to them, they can't get past it, and it's a block right there. Mm-hmm. I'm telling you,
that's
the,
why
the guy that we
be...
talked to, I ain't gonna mention his name, but it happened down here. Somebody got pushed in the background so far in their career, and they felt like it was caused by somebody that was bigger than them. And when the song came out, bam, it didn't work out the way they thought it did, and it messed that boy head up.
It's mental.
Did you hear what I just said? They care. I know you love it.
It's mental.
But you know, in a lot of different ways, what God has for you is for you. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, you have some people want something so bad they keep pushing, and they don't realize that why they're not getting anywhere because you have another path you need to be on.
Great.
You understand what I mean? People have not accepted their destiny. They're pushing because they want this so bad, but God is showing them somewhere that they need to go, and they will actually be more profitable if they went that way. Not only that, if you fill your spirit with negativity, it's not going to benefit you anything. And a lot of people be watching other people and hating so much and wondering why they can't get anywhere themselves. They turn around and blame everybody else for where they are in life and not hold themselves accountable. And the moment that they can hold themselves accountable, they can realize. It's just like when... I love what we do because I meet so many great people and I hear so many stories.
Yeah.
And when people talk about, I have grown men who say, well, the reason why I ended up in prison or I was fighting all the time as a kid growing up, I didn't have my father in my life. And I didn't realize that the reason why I lashed out is because he wasn't there. Nobody, not even my mom knew that that's the reason why. As I got older, I realized that's the reason why I end up in prison. I end up killing somebody. I end up doing this. But sometimes we have to go through things to look back on our life to say,
I'm past it.
I need to break this trend. Because a lot of times it's my daddy or my mama went through the same thing and you're not realizing that.
It's the curse.
It's the curse. People have to put in their head, I'm not going to let my children be me. I have to break this curse right now. You see what I mean?
My mom ain't love me, well, I'm going to love my kids.
Some people overdo it though.
Yeah, but you got to, but that's what I'm saying. That was a great
balance.
That was a great
breakdown right now.
That was a great breakdown because that's what we dwell on. That's what I pound on. Like, I was that person. That's what I'm telling you. I was that person. It's crazy you just said that because my dad did, my mom did. I ain't get it. But that's just us being human and it's okay to be emotional.
Mm-hmm.
But after you done being emotional, you have to see like, okay, cool, bro. I have to find a direction because we can all be on this same street, bro. You might see somebody walking down the street. You might see a stray cat down the street. You might see a car with no lights on coming down the street. But bro, while you in your car, drive your car. Pay attention to your car.
My old granddaddy told me you can't catch no fish watching my line.
You feel me?
You know what I'm talking about? I get it, man.
You feel me? So that's like, I was that person. And that's why I feel like I can express myself. Like when you see me on that stage and I'm
jumping. That energy.
That's me rejoicing. Like, that's me just giving thanks. That's me just being in my zone. That's just me. It's just everything just me at that point. It's about myself, me being happy. I just really can't explain it because it's like, why would I be? I spent so much time being angry with my daddy to the point like my life was passing.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Have you forgiven him?
Forgave him.
Yes, sir.
Do y'all have a relationship? Is he still alive?
Relationship.
That's good.
It's a relationship that I need from here on till God come get me.
Mm-hmm. Wow, and that's dope. Cause
your mom too.
You got a value.
Same way.
Got a good value. Let me ask you this, man, and we're gonna go all the way back. Mm-hmm. How did you and K Camp and all that? That's the first mm-hmm. start of the legacy, right?
Yeah. I mean, I was already grinding. You know what I'm saying? Cub with me, you know what I'm saying?
Y'all young boys, man.
Young, spend night in the studio.
Young boy.
Near the studio. He was every step, bro. From the day I started. Really, he was rapping first. Then, you know what I'm saying? Of course.
I'm about to get you. You're going to be back over here today. Yeah. Stop playing, man.
Okay,
Because I didn't plan it, but I don't want to miss out on something.
Yeah. He can do it. Hell yeah.
Okay, because I just got the other guy. If you're willing to wait.
We have two more out there.
Two more? Mm-hmm. Okay.
When you get into the music, you're going to be.
Man, I just love the fact of how y'all grind and y'all hungry for it, man. And really it's something that helps. It's helping the people, man, around mm-hmm. you. The more music you make and the way that you move, the more people you're helping, your family. You're helping people to see things clearer through these mics, through your story. Mm-hmm. That's what it's all about.
It's iron sharpen iron.
Exactly, mm-hmm.
If it's great fruit, I don't mind giving to everybody.
Yeah.
It's great. It's fresh. You need it, I need it, we all need it. Take it. If it's bad, we don't feed each other that.
How do you, so top three artists of all time, dead or alive?
Any genre.
I ask this question to every guest.
Male or female?
Top three. Number one.
Future.
Number two.
I like Future.
Tupac.
Number three.
Outcast.
He just tied it.
He just tied it with
the other guy getting them back to back.
Yeah. That was quick.
Because normally people had to be
talented.
Man, Outcast dope, man.
I love Outcast. They are.
I love Andre. Sorry, not Outcast.
Andre. Whoa. You can't go with
Andre. I gotta break it down.
Because Andre feeding your spirit.
I like his style. Yeah. I like everything about him.
He feeding our spirit.
But Future, man.
He feeding the spirit.
That nigga know how to make a hit, boy. Y'all better stop playing. You better get your stuff together if you're gonna come behind him too. Who would you like to work with in the industry that you haven't?
Rod Wave.
Okay.
It's somebody else who I said, bro. It's a lot of people I listen to. I'm gonna work with Deidre Haddon.
Okay.
He's a gospel singer.
I know.
Yeah, Deidre Haddon.
Dope.
Yep. I love music.
Have you ever done anything gospel before?
Nah.
But you can go there. You can do it.
I can go there.
So
I just don't want to play with God like that. I can go there though.
I don't think it's playing with God.
It's
so dope how you can transcend things that people got in their natural mind. My daughter taught me this. She don't like the way certain things are culturized or put in a set standard. You got to be free, man. We got to stop acting as if these little standards that people put into place, you say, I don't want to play with God. Is it really playing with God? Do you love God?
It's the art, then.
You see what I'm saying?
So I appreciate the correction.
It? No, yeah. Explain,
I appreciate
the correction. Explain what you mean.
Yeah, I appreciate the correction. Okay. I'm very passionate, as you can see.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, once I give it my time and give it my space or whatever it is I'm doing with it, I want to be true to it. And like I told God before I even asked him to start, before I gave him my life, you know what I'm saying? I asked him, could he protect me or whatever? You got to really do that. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? I had to really know. You can't, it's like, it can go seven different ways with this, what I'm finna say.
Go ahead.
It's like, you don't really have to, I know God because what I learned. Not what nobody taught me, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, dope.
And I try to, so now I know it's Yahweh Messiah, so I know it get deeper.
It gets deeper.
What I'm saying? So
this, El Shaddai, all that. But anytime you dealing with God, a life period, you got to have balance.
So this is why I'm finna, and I'm trying to understand okay, God, I'm with it.
Yeah.
And you know what I'm saying? Before I even started saying, yeah, God, I had to honestly tell him I'm fucked up. And he
everybody.
I was young, so I didn't know if he knew that. I was young, I didn't know if he knew that or not.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
God is a forgiving God. That's the one person
But you know what really happens?
I didn't know that though.
People paint this picture of what you see in your imagery of who God is, and it'd be wrong. You see what I'm saying? You can't go by what they say. You got to go by what he say. So you don't have to worry about his relationship, her relationship, hers or hers. It's between you and God. It got nothing to do with nobody else.
I do what Lil Baby did.
So you don't even have
though.
To worry about that.
I do something like what Lil Baby did. That's hard.
That's hard. Because you can help people where you at. It don't matter,
see,
man.
That's what I was.
Some people can't reach people you could reach. So whatever it takes.
I do that.
If you did a song with Diedrich Halley or whoever, whoever you done it with, it's gonna come off right.
Cause he know my heart. Period.
Yeah, exactly. One thing I love about entertainers is the fact that y'all have such a wide platform that you affect through your music, through your mic.
Yeah.
And tomorrow's never promised.
Yep.
Dope.
So if you can come out with something that can help someone, mm-hmm. educate them, I mean, turn them from going down the wrong path.
Mm-hmm. Reach the people.
Reach the people. All because right. they look at you and they can see themselves.
They look for a voice.
They look for a voice. And when they believe in you and they listen to you and you say something positive, you could change a life.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
I'm with that. I'm with that. Okay, y'all just made me feel different.
That's all, man. We just saying, man. We just ride. We salute. Just vibing.
That's what we here for. That's what we here for.
And I appreciate that. Salute.
That's what we use this platform for. We use this platform to help others. When you talk about your relationship with your father and how you overcame it and how you have a great relationship now, you have some people right now who can't even do that. They don't even care if their father passed away tomorrow.
Ooh.
They'll be like, I wouldn't even look at his grave.
Yeah.
And all I can do is pray for them because it's going to hurt them 20 years from now.
It's going to hurt
or their
them.
Kids. Right. It's going to hurt them. It's not hurting their father. Their father's already dead and gone. But what I'm saying is that their kids can turn around and do the same thing to them and they're wondering, why are you acting like that?
But still, you got to understand the
generational curse.
Yeah.
He's like, hey man, Boss Talk 101, man, it's going down, man. Hey, we doing it. It's going in. Hey man, my boy, man, Mykko Montana was in the building.
Yes, sir.
Say, man. So you coming to see me in Texas?
Yes, I'll never
know that, man.
Yes, we is.
And we coming back to Atlanta. This is a family affair. It's going down, man. Dig. This ain't the last time, man. It's only the first time. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm talking about?
Most definitely.
So, man, you know.
You locked in now.
Yeah, you family, man. We love you, bro. Like
thank
I said,
you,
what would you say to that young brother that was working with K-Camp back in the days? I'm gonna ask you that. What would you say to him to tell him to get ready for the ride that y'all was headed for, as far as what he's about to go through, what he's about to face?
Trust yourself.
Okay.
Trust your instinct. You know what I'm saying? Don't be in a rush.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And enjoy the music, bro. Enjoy the moment,
right?
Yeah, enjoy the moment, bro.
That's it.
I took it to the heart, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
And I understand because other people, they come in as artists and their parents done taught them. Like, you got to be, everybody's household ain't like yours. So if you coming into it and they like, they already know them, but it ain't their business to tell you like, yo, we got a lawyer. Yep, we got published. Yep, so when this song go out, he's going to get percentage. Like, Mykko just think he just can come in here and just make a song and just throw it out. You know what I'm saying? Everybody be prepared, but yeah. Now I'm ready now.
And I like that because a lot of people don't be prepared. They don't know. And then once you go through something, see, that what don't kill you make you stronger, right?
And then they want a bad relationship.
I just say, help the next young brother that might be going through it, man. Don't leave him hanging. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to, bro. Because at the end of the day, that's going to help you.
If you can help you,
No. A lot of people didn't tell you or couldn't reach you, but it's that person that you probably can reach. I'm just saying, spit that information out there, man. Do the interviews, man. Come out here and let people know how things changed for you. You know, how you was able to reinvent and all that good stuff. You know what I'm saying?
For the spirit, bro.
Yeah.
Just show love. You have to always show love. There's times in life when you feel that negative vibe coming over you. Everybody go through it. And sometimes, for me personally, it could be nothing even happened that was bad. All of a sudden, I just start feeling that negative vibe. And I know what it is. And I say, you know what, devil, you're not going to win today. And I just, you know, you have to change your thinking because everything starts here before you act everything out.
Dang, that's real.
So you got to recognize it at that point and say, you're not going to mess my day up. Change your thinking and share positivity.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, man. Hey, man, we can't wait to do it again, right?
Yes,
this is a great interview, man.
I'm loving it,
man. I love the vibe, bro. Like, we just have a real talk. That's all we be doing.
We ain't into
all that other stuff. It's real talk, and I'm going to keep it that way, too. We ain't going to know, hey, we trying to find. No, we just talking. We just happy to be, you know, in the presence of you. We want to sit down and kick
whatever
it with
whatever you let out, you let out, because we've had people who come on here, and they letting out negativity, but by the time we were done with them, they turned that negative conversation into something positive. Because I always try to show everybody there's a positive way. When you think that this person is hating and that person is hating, that person is trying to hold you down, I was like, no, you got to change your thinking. Stop trying to be negative towards everybody else. It's how you perceive anything that somebody do to you is how you perceive it.
Mm-hmm. How you take it.
That person might not even mean it in a negative way. But because you perceive it as negative.
But he might mean it in a negative way as well.
But guess what?
But whatever.
If you don't dwell on it, you can always think it's positive, even if it is negative.
Your spirit be ready for it.
Yeah.
Exactly.
This is the game now. Like, this is what me and my team on, like, from this day forward, like, or what they on individually by themselves. Like, but this is a mental game.
definitely
in this second quarter of life, right? Yes, in this second quarter of life right now, bro, it's all mental.
Definitely. Hey, man, thank you, man. Thank you, man. Hey, man, we love you, bro.
Love you too,
man. Man, listen, Mykko Montana, it's going down, man.
Yes, sir.
I done met you.
Yes,
it's going down. When you come to D-Town, I'm be like, yeah, you got to go here, and here.
You did.
It's going down.
I'm getting my deep Dallas swag. I'm getting all that going on.
Already, man. Check it, man.
I stayed out there before, though.
That's what I'm saying.
I stayed in Oklahoma City with my daddy.
I'd have brought you right on through D. You know, but you were younger then.
Yeah, and I remember like how their market, man, that
market is there.
Say, that wasn't rapping then, though, player.
But that's what I'm saying. We about to get to it.
Let's
say, man, check it, man. It's been another great segment of Boss Talk 101.
And we out.